let's take stock of where you are. You start with a graph G. From G, you can construct its Laplacian, L of G. Now, suppose you have a partition of G. That implies a partitioning of the vertices into two sets, call them V plus or V minus. In linear algebraic terms, you can translate this vertex partition into a partition vector. Each vertex I is assigned to one partition or the other, designated by a plus one or a minus one. Now, suppose you want to know the number of cut edges in G. Then you can count it algebraically. That suggests that partitioning could be viewed as choosing an X to minimize this quantity. So this becomes a combinatorial optimization problem. Formally, we want an X that minimizes the number of cut edges, subject to two conditions. First, you want to assign every vertex to one partition or the other, and you want the same number of vertices in each partition. This problem is, unfortunately, NP-complete. Rats! So to work around that, let's relax the problem a little. Let's start by taking away the requirement that we assign exactly a plus one or a minus one to every vertex. If you do so, then there's a really neat fact we can use. This fact combines everything we know about graph Laplacians along with a cool theorem from linear algebra called the Courant-Fisher-Minimax theorem. If we're allowed to use any vector y, where y is normalized in a certain way and its elements sum to zero, then the vector y that minimizes this quantity is actually q1. q1, you'll remember, is the eigenvector corresponding to the second smallest eigenvalue. And in fact, the minimum value simplifies to something that is proportional to that eigenvalue. So what does this mean? Let's go back to the original optimization problem. Our most recent fact tells us that the optimal value is at least this quantity. To turn all this into an algorithm, you need one more idea. Choosing x to be q1 gives us a lower bound on the thing we want. But how do we take a q1 and actually turn it into something that is a partition vector? In other words, something that has plus or minus one values in all the entries. Do you remember our spring analogy? In fact, the Laplacian derived from this spring system gives us a second smallest eigenvector that looks like this. If you plot the components of the eigenvector for the second smallest eigenvalue, you'll get something that looks like this. It's sine curvy because that's what the fundamental modes of the spring system look like. And as it turns out, half of its elements are positive and the other half are negative. So that suggests the following algorithm. First, compute the Laplacian for the graph. Then compute its second smallest eigenpair. Then determine the partition using the signs of the components of the eigenvector. So that was a lot of work, but the final algorithm is very compact. And indeed, for planar algorithms, it works really, really well. Here are two examples of what the spectral partitioning algorithm produces on two graphs. Hey, someone should make a t-shirt out of these.